Sydney. R. Shaw, one vote. Geelong. J. Corey, two votes. Geelong. G. Ablett, three votes.
And that means, Gary, you can't be beaten. You now lead by seven votes with just two rounds remaining. Firstly, I'll say to you, we've got two rounds remaining, but congratulations.
Thanks, Mark.
You were hoping the umpires might have picked up that performance and they didn't let you down.
Yeah, look, I can't add up too well, so if you can just read the last two out, that'd be good.
Look, we'll let you gather your thoughts, but no worries. After 3 years, you're home and hosed. Think about it. We'll go to highlights now of round 21.
Forget about finals. What about pride?
For the second week running, the siren sounded pain for the Saints.
Not again.
As it was deja vu.
It was touched.
The Dogs dished out loss number four for the Cats, but little Gaz still racked up big numbers with 40 possessions. Adam Goods also shone in the losing side as the Pies and Brad Dick were once again on target.
Well, that's a dead eye, Dick.
But for Ben Cousins, it was more dead stiff than dead eye after this bump from Bunny.
He stopped Cousins in his tracks.
Round 21. Fremantle versus Essendon. Fremantle, Al McFarlane, one vote. Fremantle, A. Sandlands, two votes. Fremantle, M. Pavlich, three votes. Richmond versus Hawthorn. Hawthorn, S. Mitchell, one vote. Richmond, B. Deledio, two votes. Hawthorn, L. Hodge, three votes. Adelaide versus West Coast. Adelaide, J. Porplesia, one vote. Adelaide, M. Dowdy, two votes. Adelaide, S. Goodwin, three votes. Brisbane versus Port Adelaide. Brisbane, D. Bradshaw, one vote. Port Adelaide, D. Brogan, two votes. Brisbane, L. Power, three votes. Collingwood versus Sydney. Collingwood, J. Anthony, one vote. Sydney, A. Goods, two votes. Collingwood, D. Beams, three votes. St. Kilda versus North Melbourne. North Melbourne, D. Petrie, one vote. St. Kilda, N. Revolt, two votes. North Melbourne, A. Swallow, three votes. Carlton versus Melbourne. Carlton, M. Murphy, one vote. Carlton, B. Favola, two votes. Carlton, C. Judd, three votes. Western Bulldogs versus Geelong. Western Bulldogs, J. Harbrow, one vote. Western Bulldogs, M. Boyd, two votes. Geelong, G. Ablett, three votes.
Another bumpy week in footy as emotions boiled over on the field and off it.
He can't believe it. John O'Donnell put the Western Bulldogs in third spot.
The game's happiest player had reason to smile as the Dogs got the jump on the Pies. It was the Nick show for St Kilda.
Wonderful by Revolt.
Six goals from Revolt, 39 possessions from Dal Santo. And the Saints were once again winners.
Good finish.
And after a 72-point win over the Blues, the Crows went into the finals on a high. Any higher, and their feathers would have got stuck in the roof.
Oh! Outro the mark to the century!
Round 22. Port Adelaide versus North Melbourne. Port Adelaide, D. Cassisi, one vote. Port Adelaide, R. Gray, two votes. North Melbourne, J. Gibson, three votes. West Coast versus Richmond. West Coast, A. Embley, one vote. West Coast, M. Lacroix, two votes. West Coast, T. Swift, three votes. Hawthorn versus Essendon. Hawthorn, S. Mitchell, one vote. Essendon, M. Hurley, two votes. Essendon, B. Stanton, three votes. Collingwood versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, B. Johnson, one vote. Collingwood, H. Shaw, two votes. Western Bulldogs, B. Lake, three votes. Carlton versus Adelaide. Adelaide, C. Knights, one vote. Adelaide, A. McLeod, 2 votes. Adelaide, B. Vince, 3 votes. Sydney versus Brisbane. Sydney, A. Goods, 1 vote. Brisbane, M. Clark, 2 votes. Brisbane, S. Black, 3 votes. Melbourne versus St Kilda. St Kilda, Al Hayes, 1 vote. St Kilda, N. Revolt, 2 votes. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, 3 votes. Geelong versus Fremantle. Geelong, G. Ablett, 1 vote. Geelong, D. Milburn, 2 votes. Geelong, J. Bartel, 3 votes. I declare the winner of the 2009 Brownlow Medal, Gary Ablett of the Geelong Football Club.
As Gary makes his way forward to a standing ovation, I call upon the chairman of the AFL Commission, Mike Fitzpatrick, and the reigning Brownlow medalist, Adam Cooney, to come forward for the presentation.
Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Ablett of Geelong, one of the game's premier midfielders, drafted under the father-son rule from Motowari and the Geelong Falcons. Debuted in 2002, played 167 games, All-Australian last 3 years as a midfielder. Winner of the last 3 AFLPA MVP awards as nominated by his peers. Third in last year's Brownlow Medal and finished fourth in 2007. Winner of the club's second Brownlow Medal in 3 years after Jimmy Bartel in 2007. In 2007 was part of the club's first Premiership since 1963. Son of Australian Football Hall of Fame member, Gary Ablett Sr. May I now ask Adam Cooney to present the 2009 Brownlow Medal to Gary Ablett. Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding. Charge your glasses. To celebrate the winner of the 2009 Brownlow Medal, Gary Ablett from Geelong.
Gary Ablett.
Gary Ablett. Well done.
Better save that. Thank you, Michael. And thank you very much to Adam Cooney. Would you put your hands together for Michael and Adam and thank them for their participation? Three years goes pretty quickly, doesn't it?
It does, mate. Yeah, it still feels so surreal. I'm shaking.
It's fantastic. I was watching you down there with Lauren. She hasn't got the smile off her face since when you got to 28 votes, and I don't know who looked happier, you or her.
I know. She's had to put up with a lot of my complaining over the years, and yeah, I think she's just stoked that I'll be going home happy tonight. So.
We're so glad you are going home happily tonight because last year it seemed to me that it was like a real kick in the guts for you. Were you absolutely shattered by that?
Oh, not really. Look, you know, Cooney deserved it. He had a fantastic season and, yeah, I mean, he was obviously, you know, the best player of the year and well-deserved his award for sure.
Who was more nervous tonight, you or Lauren?
I think we were both very nervous, so... I don't know what to say, mate. I'm still shaking a bit.
It's an amazing week, isn't it? You know, you've got a chance to win a Brownlow and a Norm Smith in the one week.
Yeah, look, I'm not thinking about the Norm Smith too much, mate. You know, it's fantastic. We've got another shot at the Premiership. you know, the guys are very excited about, you know, about having another crack, and we think we've got the team to do it, so we're looking forward to getting in on Saturday.
Well, your dad might be thinking about it because it's his 20th anniversary tonight of winning his, or this week of winning his Norm Smith. I would imagine at this very minute he'd be tickled pink.
He would be stoked for me. It's going to be fantastic that I can go home and say I've done something that he hasn't done. So I'm excited about that. But yeah.
You've had an incredibly stable group down there at Geelong in the last 3 years. I think a couple of weeks ago, 18 of the 22 played in the 2007 Premiership side. That must be so beneficial to each and every player.
It is for sure. I mean, they're a fantastic bunch of blokes down there. We're really close down there as a group. As I said, we're really looking forward to having another shot at it this weekend. Hopefully we can bring home that Premiership Cup. It'd be fantastic.
We often see shots of Coach Bomber Thompson in the coach's box. He's a very laid-back man. He'd sit there eating salad sandwiches or drinking Coke. Does he ever actually fire up?
Yeah, he does behind the scenes.
He does.
Definitely does. Yep. No, but I mean, yeah, he's normally pretty calm, and I've copped a few sprays in my time. So, most of the time he's pretty good, and he's switched on to what's going on. So, and he's a great coach, and yeah, he's a big part of the reason why we're having another shot at a premiership.
Just changing tack for a moment, Gary. A number of elite sportsmen like to meet other elite sportsmen. Tiger Woods is coming out here, of course, for the Masters. Would you like to meet him?
Oh, yeah, I guess that'd be good. I'm going to go along and...
Well, he probably wants to meet you.
I don't know about that, mate. I don't know about that. But, yeah, I'll go along and watch it. I enjoy my golf, so, I'll go along. But I don't think he'd be interested in meeting me.
What about this week? I mean, you're on an absolute high at the moment. Now you've got to settle down, get your mind back on the job. Can you actually enjoy the next few days before Saturday?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, we're, the last 2 years we've gone in pretty relaxed, and, I'm sure I'll forget about it after tonight and get back and get into training and do what I would normally do in a week and normally prepare and get into the game on Saturday. So I don't think it'd be too hard. We've got another chance at a premiership, so.
Now, you've already slipped one into your father. Are there any other people you might like to thank? The microphone is yours.
I do. I've got heaps of people I'd like to thank. I'd like to start off by thanking my family. They've been fantastic. Just a great support throughout my whole life, not just my footy career. My beautiful girlfriend, Lauren, she's just been amazing. Always a very positive person. And when I'm down, always seems to find the right thing to say to make me smile. And also love to thank my teammates. Without you guys, I wouldn't be up here accepting this medal. It's kind of yours as well, guys, and hopefully we can get a premiership this week. It'd be fantastic.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 2009 Brownlow medalist, Gary Ablett.
Good on you, well done.
We'll take a break. Be back with more here at Brown shortly.